I've talked all about running PCVR on the Apple Vision Pro recently. One of my recent videos showed off ALVR, a way to run SteamVR on the headset over the internet, while also allowing you to use hand and eye tracking in your gameplay. I wanted to make a tutorial showing how to install ALVR and set it up because while it's easy to install it, it requires a bit more effort to get it running just like this. So let's just jump right into it. Before that though, there's a list of requirements that you need in order to run the experience well. The hardware requirements are pretty light. The most important thing is that you have your router nearby and that you're using the 5GHz antenna on it. Once you get that done, you can download the most recent version of the ALVR streamer on their GitHub, which is linked down in the description. Make sure that it's the streamer and not the launcher, and that you're choosing the .exe file for Windows or tar.gz file for Linux. Sorry, VR Mac users, but you probably don't exist, so it's fine. Once it's done downloading, extract the file and then open up the ALVR dashboard application located in the folder. This should open up a window with information to set the app up. Follow all the steps in the setup wizard, it's all pretty self-explanatory. If you ever want to change these settings, you can just go to the settings on the app itself. Once you're done setting ALVR up, make sure that your SteamVR is downloaded. If it is, we can switch to the Vision Pro now. So there's two different versions of ALVR for the Vision Pro. There's the App Store version that gets updated once in a while and is pretty easy to download. Then, for the people who want bleeding edge features like eye tracking and twice as many bugs, there's a beta test flight version. To install the latter, you first need to install Apple's official test flight app. Then, you can go to the link in the description to join the beta test for ALVR. If it says it's full, you'll have to use a regular version until spots are free. Once you have one of them installed, you can open it up and here's where the magic happens. Going back to your computer of choice, you can now hit the Launch SteamVR button on the bottom left of the ALVR streamer. The PC should now show the Vision Pro in the New Devices area, to which you can click on Trust. If for some reason it doesn't show up, you can click on the Add Device Manually button and add in the hostname and IP address, found at the bottom of the Vision Pro app. If it still doesn't work, you might need to restart ALVR on both devices or consult the official troubleshooting page for help. The final step is going back to your Vision Pro headset and then tapping on the Enter button down below. If all is working properly, you'll wait around 15 seconds and then boom, you're in SteamVR now. I don't really come here often, so this SteamVR home is pretty nostalgic for me. If you have Index controllers and base stations that you want to use here, you can follow this Reddit tutorial for that specific process. If you just want to use your hands to move around, you have to go to the ALVR streamer on your computer and then in the Presets tab in Settings, near the bottom where it says Hand Tracking Interaction, click on ALVR Bindings. Restart your SteamVR and, when you come back, you'll be able to move and turn with just your hands. The movement system is basically a virtual joystick, so you have to curl your hands into a fist and then move your thumb around in the direction that you want to move and turn. Here's the default control bindings if you need them. It works well once you get used to it, especially if you have lots of lighting in your room. And the best part is all of your fingers are tracked, so you can show people how you truly feel about them. Bus controllers apparently do work with ALVR, but they require a more advanced setup and I've never done it before, so I'll link a 4-minute tutorial down below if you want to look into it yourself. I think the coolest feature that ALVR on the Vision Pro offers is eye tracking for games like VRChat. It's not necessary at all, heck, most games don't even support it, but if you play VRChat and want to make your character livelier, here's how to set it up. Side note, at this time of recording, it only works on the test flight version in my experience, so keep that in mind. First, you'll need to go into your ALVR streamer on your computer and then in the presets menu in settings, the final setting is called Eye and Face Tracking. Click on VRChat Eye OSC. Then, on your Vision Pro, you go into your control center, hold the record button, and then there will be an option called Send Eye Tracking to ALVR. Once you do that, you can open ALVR on the headset, go into settings, and then turn on the experimental 40ppd renderer. By the time that you're watching this, it might go by a different name or even be enabled by default, so look in the official GitHub page for more information. After turning it on, you can go into VRChat now and eye tracking should work. Make sure that you're using an avatar that has eyes that can move, then just walk up to a mirror and look around. Currently, it's pretty shaky and crazy as you can see here, but by the time that you're watching this, it might be fixed. Look at you, so lucky for living in the future. For settings, I just bumped up all of the settings in the presets menu on the ALVR streamer, and then on the Vision Pro I lowered the FOV scale from 1 to 0.9. This means that everything will be sharper, but at the cost of sometimes seeing this black bar when you look around and shake your head around. The other setting settings are pretty self-explanatory, and if not, you can always just consult the GitHub. If you had any problems with any steps during this video, like connecting the Vision Pro to SteamVR or stuttering, consult the ALVR troubleshooting page in the description. It's pretty comprehensive. Otherwise, just use the Discord to chat with other ALVR users and the devs about your problem. The worst place to ask for help is in this comment section, since I'm just a dumb YouTuber and I didn't code this app. If you just want to vent in the comments, or you're a person that didn't get to this part of the video, then go ham, I guess. Anyways, that's all for today. Make sure to like and subscribe for more epic troubleshooting footage just like this one. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and take care!